Welcome to the Raduga venue in the hills above Krasnoyarsk in the heart of Siberia. Ski orienteering events have been held on this terrain for nearly 60 years, but history's being made this week as the sport makes its first appearance at a Universiade. And today's action will be the men and women's middle distance races. The preparations are underway, an unseasonably warm week in Krasnoyarsk. But today's concluding races in the ski orienteering will see some really wintry conditions. So the skis being prepared differently from what we've seen earlier on in this Universiade. The athletes warming up, and they really need to today. Temperatures sub-zero, and it's the first time we are at this venue and seen the snow falling. It's been some glorious weather the last week with bright sunshine, but not today, as 50 men and 40 women from 20 countries will complete three loops of the middle distance course. The fastest winning time this afternoon here in Krasnoyarsk expected to be around 40 to 42 minutes, and that of course depends on the state of the tracks. And looking at those conditions, I think we can expect the tracks, although groomed, to be quite slow. Ski orienteer Markku Vaukkanen's in the studio to take us through the course.
The athletes will take three loops in the terrain. This is the first loop with the forking in the beginning and then a joint part of the race. Then second loop with the forking again, coming together at the third control 11th in our competition here. And then it's common course from the second loop, third control, 11th control into the finish. And the third loop is here in the end. It is about 4 minutes, and that's where the medals will be decided.
And our start list with the 50 men representing 20 countries. It'll be a mass start, and they'll go in the finishing order from the pursuit race. So out in front, the favorite from Russia, Sergei Gorlanov, and Vladislav Kiselyov of Russia right behind him. But look out for the Finns and the Norwegians. They're all on good form. They've all got medals to their names already, and they're looking for one final gold in this final ski orienteering race for the men. So there is Gorlanov, the favorite, the darling of the home crowd. His teammate. And then come the Finns. Tuomala, Jürgen Backlid of Norway in there as well, as is Øyvind Wiggen. So they look at the map for the very first time. This is their first glimpse of what is a very technical, complicated orienteering map to try and make sense of. And the men's middle distance is away at the 29th Winter Universiade in Krasnoyarsk. And it'll all be about who can get away from the rest of the field early on in that first loop. They'll make their way out of the stadium into the forest, and this time on this wide open track is an opportunity for them to take a look at that map to work out a route that they want to follow. And we will find out imminently who is going in which direction as the forking begins. No change near the front of the main pack.
And we could see Sergei Gorlanov taking the lead here, and we spoke to him prior to the start, and his goal and his plan is to go out very strongly and try to pull away from the pack before the final third loop.
And the others we spoke to, the others in the hunt for a gold, have all said that their aim in the early stages is to stick to the shirt tails of Sergei Gorlanov, not let him get away. They want to be in the hunt.
And now the athletes are approaching the fourth control there. You can see the two route choices coming together at the fourth control. And Øyvind Wiggen taking the fastest route there and being in the lead now for the fourth control.
this will be our leader from Norway. Øyvind Vigen of Norway out alone. And there you can see the gap between him and the rest. And on a race this long, that is not much of an advantage. But can he build on it over the next few kilometres? Schroderus of Finland in the mix there. So is Madslien, the other Norwegian. Valheim of Sweden. And Kiselyov of Russia, just on the far side of the camera there. The two groups have come together.
There are a number of potential route choices here towards the eight control, which will be located on the arena. So the athletes will be here in a couple of minutes, and we can see that they are now approaching the downhill section with Jørgen Barkley there pushing forward behind Garlanov, who took the lead on the seven control.
We're with our ski cam, and you can see how tight and rough these tracks are and how easy it is to catch a ski. And we've seen plenty of fallers in this competition over the last week. And the leaders still together on this track. 1, 2 and 3, Gorlinov, Kiselyov and Backlid. Two Russians, both 22 years old. Jürgen Backlid, 23, and following his tactics to the letter. Also in the mix here, Norway's Audun Heimdall, who's had a terrific Universiad, and he's still be hoping to grab a medal out of this. But 17 seconds is a gap that is now getting more and more difficult to close. That's Toivonen of Finland.
The leading Gorlanov and Barkley are soon coming towards the second last control, and they are all in for the medals.
So penultimate control, and there's a split. The Russians have gone right. Backlid has gone left. And now it all comes down to who's taken the right decision.
I think the Russians did, but we will see.
Do you think that's because Backlid felt that he did not have a chance in a sprint against them? He thought he'd have to pull something out of the hat?
Might be. It is psychologically really hard place, and we can see them coming from two different directions to the stadium.
Our leaders are going to come together, and we'll get a good idea of who took the right orienteering decision. This is Backlid.
And he's in the lead.
And Backlid has entered the arena out in front. So Backlid took the right decision. A stroke of genius with the map. And that has put Jürgen Backlid of Norway in a gold medal position. But he still has a few hundred metres to go as he approaches this final bend. Right behind him, Sergei Gorlinov, cheered on by the home fans. And now Backlid begins his sprint down the home straight towards the finish line. This is leg-bursting, lung-busting stuff. But he has it. He takes gold for Norway, Jürgen Backlid. Sergei Gorlinov just couldn't do it. A few seconds behind for silver. And it's Vladislav Kiselyov who settles for the bronze. Now, interesting as well, the fourth place. Audun Heimdall comes in. He's been there for much of the final couple of loops. And he held on to that fourth medal. Congratulations between teammates. But a terrific race from the Norwegian, Jørgen Backlid. So confirmation of the medals. But in the men's middle distance, it's victory for Norway. For Jürgen Backlid, it's silver for Sergei Gorlanov of Russia and bronze for his teammate Vladislav Kiselev. The ladies' middle distance, 40 women from 14 countries, and we expect the winner to finish in around 40 minutes' time. And the athletes excited for this final event in the ski orienteering. But what will the technicians have done to their skis? How will they have prepared them? Well, that preparation can take 8 hours at times, as the Russians discuss tactics with their coach.
Mama, привет.
Marku Valkonen in the studio to talk us through the course.
In the beginning, we have a forking, two controls before they come to our first TV control, then a joint part of the race until the sixth control, where we have a TV point, and then descend to the arena. Second loop, the forking again in two first controls, and then from the third control onwards, the ladies will have a common course towards the end, and as in men's race, we will have a ski through the arena and then a short, about 3 minutes, a final lap where the medals will be decided.
This is how they line up. It's a mass start, but it's in the finishing order of the pursuit race. As we look down the 40 athletes competing here in the women's middle distance. And the ladies' middle distance race is away. The final ski orienteering race of this 29th Universiade here in Krasnoyarsk. And they make their way out of the arena under the floodlights as the sun sets over the forest. And now they will be choosing their routes, trying to glimpse the fastest, shortest tracks. But of course, they go on two separate forking courses. And at this point, they won't know who their nearest, which way their nearest opponents will be going.
This is probably the most nervous moment of the race, getting well to the map and then through the first forking controls. Mirka Suutari taking again an unorthodox route choice, staying on completely on the white track. She will be losing some seconds on this route choice, and the athletes will be basically all together on the seventh control.
Our first look at the leader, Mirka Suutari of Finland. She's emerging from the forest. And this will be a chance to see the distance between her and Hantsheva in the light blue, just going off through the trees there. So these are our leaders.
A lot of different route choices from the athletes. Vjatkina, Tuuli Suutari, Liisa Nenonen on the B, and Hantsheva, as well as Mirka Suutari on A variant. And there we can see Hantsheva choosing a straighter route and Mirka Suutari going from the right. So very bold decisions from ladies to take different route choices at this stage of the race. Mirka Suutari here, she was slightly behind the group of three, and now she's trying to take her own choice and probably lost now a chance for medal.
So Mirka Suutari taking a shortcut, but it hasn't paid off. She falls and is out of the running right now. These are our leading three, with Liisa Nieminen, the other Finn, in third, Hantsheva in second, and Marina Vjatkina in the lead for Russia. Almost 31 minutes raced. The clock is ticking down. The track is getting shorter and shorter. It's one short loop as they exit the arena. And this is Mirka Sutari, who's got it all wrong in these last few meters. And she's now, well, she can only ski as fast as possible and just hope that the leading three make mistakes. So Vietkina leads them into the arena, and that is why the crowd are shouting. They see their Russian athlete out in front, ahead of Nainen of Finland and Hantcheva of the Czech Republic. And now it's all about who has the legs to get them around and across the finish line first.
It's very short, about 4 minute loop left. And it's interesting to see whether we get the similar final as we had in men's race, where Jørgen Barklind took his own route, which was successful.
So we're heading for a sprint finish. And in about 5 minutes time, these same athletes will be entering the arena and racing down the home straight to the finish line. But which one will have the advantage, if any? They finish that second loop side by side, but Vietkina making the running now as she starts loop number three. Should take them about 4 minutes or so to complete. We're watching Mirka Sutari making the best that she can after her earlier mistakes. Grabs a quick drink. Mouthful will do. Not sure she swallowed much of that.
She knows the medals have gone.
Nainen of Finland. Finland's best chance of a medal right now in this competition. This is Pusa, another Finnish competitor. But now we can see live where our leaders are. So Nainen is leading away now. Vietkina dropped back to third.
And Liisa Nenonen is there taking the control right. And now it's very interesting route choice. Will they go straight through the gully or go around on a wide track? And if Nenonen now chooses the shortest route, will the others go after her? Hantcheva does. And Vietkina follows as well.
So out of sight of the cameras, Liisa Nenonen has taken the lead from Vietkina. Then it's Hantcheva. But it's all still very, very close.
And the control point is up on the hill, so this is now the decisive moments, and Nenonen is on the lead. She's 10 meters ahead of the others.
Here's our leader, second place, right behind her, Marina Vyatkina of Russia. Vietkina looking for her fourth medal of these games.
Nenonen seems awfully strong physically there, and she's pulling away from Vietkina, but it doesn't allow any mistakes from her.
Now a long, hard climb. And Hantcheva has dropped back.
Now Nenonen will take the same route as Barklind.
Vietkina follows. So first and second are following each other down towards the arena as Petra Hantcheva is now just fighting to hold on to bronze. Only a mistake from the two leaders will see Hantcheva come back into this race. Nainen on the fast, wide track down towards the arena. There are some athletes still in the arena finishing their second loop. But we're with Liisa Nieminen of Finland, and they're in the stadium now. This is Nieminen. Nieminen leading. Viatkina in second. Hantsuva, close that gap on Viatkina. Viatkina, is she tiring? Is she slowing? But it's all eyes on the Finn, Liisa Nieminen. It's round this final bend for her. Hantsuva further back. Let's not get confused by the athletes still finishing their second loop. This is our leader, Liisa Nieminen of Finland, followed by Marina Viatkina of Russia. And Liisa Nieminen, 20 years old, sprints to that finish line. She knows she's got breathing space. And Nieminen crosses the finish line to claim gold for Finland, her third medal of these games. Marina Viatkina takes silver, her fourth medal of these games. And a plucky performance from Petra Hantsuva, who comes in to take the bronze medal for the Czech Republic. The Czech Republic's first ski orienteering medal here in Krasnoyarsk. But it's celebrations for Liisa Nieminen. And Mirka Suutari also challenging here. She comes into the finish line and she will be disappointed with fourth. A minute and 4 seconds in the end. The confirmation of the results in the ladies' middle distance with Liisa Nieminen taking gold. Then it was Russia second through Marina Viatkina and Petra Hantsuva of the Czech Republic taking bronze. And so that's the perfect climax to the ski orienteering's debut at the Winter Universiad. 21 medals contested across four disciplines. And I cannot think of a single race that didn't have the fans here in the grandstand screaming with excitement as the athletes sprinted towards the finish line. That's it from the Raduga Arena for now. Hope you've enjoyed it. From Markku Vaukkanen and from me, Alec Wilkinson, it's goodbye.